Darkness is scary. This is a fact we learn from the moment we are born. This is the reason we need lampposts in the streets and nightlights next to our beds. Ever since the days of telling ghost stories around a campfire and early Universal monster movies like Frankenstein, the threat always comes from the absence of light. This is the basic mentality of 90% of modern horror films. Annabelle, The Conjuring, Friday the 13th, Us, Sinister, Scream, all have their scariest moments at night. The viewer sits nervously, interrogating the dark screen, waiting for the jump scare, before the immense sense of relief when it cuts to the next morning and they can relax. But what happens when a threat doesn't come from darkness? What happens when a threat comes from the light? Dr. Bernice Murphy said this about daylight horror films in an online article. If you're alone in a dark house, you can always find at least some sanctuary in the comforting glare of a candle or an electric light, but no such escape is possible when the horror strikes in the brightness of daytime. Despite my research, I was unable to find one universal definition for the term daylight horror. So for the purpose of this video, daylight horror will refer to horror films or sequences which take place in broad daylight underneath a clear blue sky. And there may be no better modern example of this concept than Ari Aster's 2019 film Midsummer. The film revolves around Dani, who visits a Swedish community with her boyfriend, and is a masterclass in building dread and paranoia. The cinematography, storyline, and performances are incredible. But the most impactful feature of this film is that it all takes place in daylight. Aster himself explained that he didn't want the villagers to be menacing. They're not foreboding, there's nothing foreboding about them. It's such an effective subversion of expectations when this aesthetically pleasing film has such a dark and sinister context. The weather is always sunny, the characters are all dressed in white, suggesting innocence and purity. Every aspect of this film should be warm and opening, instead it is cold and unnerving. Of course, the idea of daylight horror is not a new one. Even in theatre, playwright Brett insisted that the house lights stay on in his plays, to give the stage a strange and alien atmosphere. Jaws, The Birds, The Wicker Man are all considered some of the greatest horror films ever made, and are all predominantly set in the day. But the most famous example of this technique is the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. The 1974 classic has more in common with allegorical arthouse pieces than it does with modern slasher films. Without the cannibalistic context, the cinematography under the Texas sun is very well done, including this shot, which was improvised on set. Although they are conflicting, some sources suggest that the daylight horror elements of this film were a result of the movie's limited budget. Director Toby Hooper realised that he wouldn't be able to afford proper lighting, so chose to use mostly natural light instead, resulting in an even more realistic and grounded film. YouTuber Ryan Hollinger made an essay film of his own in which he said, "Daylight is used to signify safety, but making some of the biggest scares occur during the day established a realistic condition for the audience. Death can come at any time." This best articulates why daylight horrors are so effective. It keeps the viewer on edge for the entire duration of the runtime. The film is able to maintain a constant state of feeling and emotion, as the audience doesn't know when they can relax, unlike standard horror films. Of course, the concept isn't always used effectively. For example, Annabelle Creation has some spooky scenes in a day, but this is due to random jump scares, rather than effectively using the setting. On the other hand, in a recent experiment measuring the scariest horror films, none of the top 5 had any elements of daylight horror. Though this may be the result of the experiment measuring heart rates from jump scares, rather than the creeping dread intention used in daylight horror films. To conclude, this horror film subgenre has offered some of the greatest films in cinema history, let alone horror. Future horror films could learn a lot from changing the classic tropes and stereotypes. And remember, that scary monster that comes out at night would be even scarier if it came out in the day.